On most Linux distributions, you can install Tmux with your package manager. For example, on a Debian-based like Ubuntu, you can use the aptitude command. Since I'm using macOS, I'm installing it with Homebrew using brew install Tmux. The best way to get started with Tmux is to read the manual. The manual is available in the man command. You can access it by running man tmux in your terminal. Reading the manual is the best way to become familiar with all the features of Tmux and how to use them. It's also a great way to learn about all the different key bindings that are available. Just to show you a little bit of what Tmux can do, I'm starting off by running a matrix visual, and I'm going to rename the window so I can understand easily where I'm at. I'm starting a new window and running top right there. So you can see in the bottom, I've just renamed that to top. I'm killing it, and I'm going to the menu where I can see all the windows, the sessions, scroll between them, open them, and see what's running currently in my Tmux session. Panes are the individual sub-windows of a Tmux window. Each pane is a separate pseudo-terminal. Any number of panes can be created in a single window, and each pane can be split horizontally or vertically. This helps maximize screen real estate and makes it easier to work with multiple terminals in the same window. As you've seen before, I have two running Tmux sessions, test 1 to 3 and 5, and I can also easily toggle between them. Let's talk a little bit about the config file. I'm going to my dot .files, where I have a subfolder that's called Tmux. Since I'm using sto to create my .config directory, I'm storing everything in .files and using sto for the symlinks. So in this instance, I'm running inside the directory, and I'll just read the config file. As you can see, two different ones, tmux.conf and tmux.conf.local. The reason for that is I'm using a special configuration, which I'll show later in this video, that helps me with ramping up. It's called .tmux, you can find it on GitHub, and it's extremely popular in the community. In my current setup, I'm not touching tmux.conf, and in order to set my own personal settings, I'm using the tmux.conf.local, and that's what you can see now. This file contains all the configuration settings for Tmux, such as key bindings, window options, and color settings. It's possible to customize Tmux to your liking by editing the file. TPM is the Tmux plugin manager, and I'll show you later how to install it and where to find it, but you can see I'm running all kinds of plugins like Resurrect, Continuum, creating sessions, even playing a Spotify playlist. I'm popping man tmux just for a second again to show what I meant earlier with the tmux configuration file. So tmux.conf can either be set with .tmux.conf in the home directory or as tmux.conf in the .config file. I'm using the .config, but it doesn't really matter. From this point on, please take a good look at my keycaster down below where you can see what keys I hit. I'm using Control A to control Tmux. This would be my prefix for every motion. Tmux uses three layers, sessions, windows, and panes. A Tmux session consists of one or more windows, and each window is split into one or more panes. Each pane is a separate terminal process. Windows are top-level containers in Tmux, and each window can contain any number of panes. In order to create a session, I hit tmux new session -t and the name, which then appears on the bottom left corner. I'm creating new splits in a combination of the prefix and h for horizontal or s for a vertical split. And moving around is done either with the arrows or prefix and brackets. In my case, I've set the vim motions and or vim arrows to switch between different panes. You can also see me zooming in and out of panes using the prefix and z attached. Hitting the prefix twice sends me to the last window that I've used. One of the fundamental features of Tmux is the ability to detach from the process and reattach yourself back into it. So I'm detaching here from my Tmux session, and I can quickly reattach myself using Tmux attach or Tmux A as a shortcut. A quick Tmux ls will show the open sessions and windows, and Control C is mapped to let me open as many windows as I want. And with the prefix and capital S, you can actually see an interactive browser. Here you can preview all the windows and jump between them. Note how every window has a name, a number, and a memory of who the last window we visited was. This is marked in gray. Hitting Ctrl D kills the process that closes the window and moving me to the last window in line. Changing a pane orientation can be done with the prefix and space. Watch how I circle between the available options. You can easily change the size of a pane by using the prefix and colon key binding to open the command prompt, and then you can use the resize pane command to adjust the size of the current one. Mine is already mapped to use the shortcut below and change sizes in increments of 10. Lastly, before moving to configuration and third-party helpers, here's a common scenario most of you know. An IDE with a console pane below. This is very common in VS Code, JetBrains products, and others. With Tmux, I can not only achieve the same, but zoom in and out of it, change its size, open additional panes below, and play with them as much as I like. This is what you call a productivity booster. I've mentioned it earlier, .tmux is one of the most popular Tmux projects on GitHub. It brings in lots of sensible configurations, a plugin boilerplate, and lots of configurations to ramp you up from the get-go. I highly recommend starting off with it and progressing your way from there. As you've seen early in the video, it brings in one tmux.conf file and another tmux.conf.local, which that's the one you change to your liking. Powerline configures your Tmux status bar for even greater productivity. It comes with its own set of plugins which are easily customizable. I'm pretty lean with mine, but you can see the battery status, date, time, and to the left I have the session, uptime, and then my Windows arrangement. You can also add email notifications, music controls, even the weather if that's what you want. Check out the README for all the other options and how to customize your own. The Tmux Plugin Manager, TPM, makes it easy to manage plugins for Tmux. It provides a simple and powerful way to extend its functionality. TPM also provides a set of helper functions to make it easier to add custom plugins to your configuration. This allows you to quickly extend the functionality of Tmux without having to write your own code. Adding a plugin is as easy as set minus G, plugin and the plugin's name, then hitting the prefix and capital I to install them. If you have any questions or would like a follow-up session on specific areas, please comment below. Check out my terminal setup video for a complete walkthrough of everything I use beyond Tmux itself.